Have you heard about ChatGPT projects? This is exactly what I will show you right now. Hi everyone, today I'd like to show you how to use ChatGPT projects. But before we go, I would like to invite you to subscribe to the channel and also to follow me on LinkedIn. These two tasks help a lot all the crew and all the work we are doing to promote AI in project management. But now I want to show you how to use. So imagine a situation that I have a portfolio of projects, and this portfolio is comprised by 15 different projects. Projects from all sources and all types. And I want to analyze them in terms of extracting information on documents, and I want to use the concept of ChatGPT projects. So let me show you. Here, what you see is the ChatGPT. I'm using ChatGPT 4.0, and I will click here, New Project. And then I will write project name. I will put Tiger Screws Portfolio. Tiger Screws Portfolio. And I will create a project. When I create a project, the project will appear here on the top and also on the sidebar, and add files. And then I will click on add files, and I will drag all the informations I have about these projects. So I have these five files I want to insert, and I will click add files. Let's take a look on them. Let's take a look on them. So we have all the files here. And let me show you the first one. The first one is the strategy map of Tiger Screw. This is the strategy. And this is the file I use in one of my workshops called the PM Rank Workshop. And this is the strategy map. It's just showing what is the strategy of Tiger Screw. The second file is a memo from the board saying, on this strategy map, I want to prioritize these topics here that are not in gray. The third file is the set of 15 projects. So I have review of product mix, then I have all the data about each of these projects. Okay, as I said, we have 15 projects here. Then I have the criteria I'm using to select a project. So each of the criteria with the scores and how the score takes place for every single project. So here I have the information about the project with the score, and here I have the criteria. And also, I just decided to also present to you the spreadsheet that combines all this information. These are the five files, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 files. What I will do now, I want to start chatting with this project. But before, I want to add some instructions. So, I am the head of the project management office of Tiger Screw. Answer the prompts, assuming the following info. Be brief and direct in all answers. Short answers are better than long. Use plain English. I am not a native speaker. Do not behave as AI. behave as Ricardo Vargas. Okay? So I'm putting the, you can put whatever you may need on this. Okay? You can put whatever you may need to instruct the behavior of this project. So when I do that, I have the instructions and the files. Now I can chat with my portfolio. What is the project with highest budget? The project with the highest budget is the internationalization of production units. Okay, perfect. Create a graph with the project's budgets with the cumulative project budget by area, by corporate area. Make a pie chart. Okay, so I'm asking to create a graphic with the cumulative project budget by corporate area. So it's analyzing the data and will create. Remember, I just uploaded PDF files. So it's incredible because it's taking this, it's to analyzing and it's giving me the answer and preparing eventually a chart or everything I may request just by using this. So now you can see. So the planning has the highest budget. And if I want to see in full screen, I just click here. Okay, I just click here. So this is an extremely easy to use and effective tool. And I can use even to ask tough questions. Considering that, for example, marketing and sales is a priority, and based on the scores of the 15 projects, please pick the projects I should select for the portfolio, considering I have a budget of 8 million. Explain your decision. And this is like magic. It's doing the work of portfolio management. So while it analyzes, what is doing? It's going, it's checking every single score, and it's doing this in a project environment. So what happens every time, for example, let's suppose you are working on a PMO and you want to go back to this discussion, you just click on the project and you will see all the posts and all the discussions. So it's like a discussion with someone that is expert on the files you just uploaded. So you can do this, for example, for one specific project and put all the documents of this project. You can do as a portfolio, like I'm showing here. You can do this for risk management. You can do this for procurement documents. So you can do this for pretty much everything. And it will make your life much easier because you don't need to give the context. And what happens? The memory of ChatGPT will start understanding that process. For example, just out of curiosity, I do this for my podcast. For example, when I need to craft a podcast and I want to make sure I have the right points in this, I have one project that contains all my podcasts, all the more than 700 episodes I recorded, to help me to craft and not become repetitive, to have new ideas, etc. So this is the use of AI to help me. Take a look. So it's saying that I should do project 10, then project 0, then project 6, project 12, project 9, project 13, and the explanation. because they belong to the marketing and sales as a priority and have the highest combined score and fit into the 8 million budget. The selected projects were these ones. Okay, and I could do that in different ways. I could ask it to use one criteria, another criteria. I can put weight on criteria. All of these using the concept of staying in one project. So when I click here on Tiger's Crew, I will go back to my Tiger's Crew portfolio and I can continue making questions. I can add files, I can add new instructions, and I can train, and this will become an expert in that portfolio. So this tool is available for free and paid users. Don't miss the opportunity to do that. I have so many projects because they help me to do my job much better. Thank you very much for joining me on this video, and please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and following me on LinkedIn. I publish videos on AI related to project management like the one we just watched. Thank you very much and see you next time.